Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do my middle finger. Because I'm doing a falsette look. You may have watched the previous video for this nail, but now we are on to the middle finger. On this finger, I am going to do a different shape. Yes, we're going to have a set with lots of different shapes as well. Oh my God. Yes, it's going to get exciting. We're going to do a Russian almond shape, or we will call it a We're going to do a Russian almond shape. Some people call it a Gothic almond. There's a very slight difference between the two. So you make up your mind what it is. So I'm going to sculpt this. I have already prepared the nail. It means I have filed the living out of it. I haven't filed the living crap out of it. I have actually removed nails, so that's why they are filed. And done cuticle work, all that. What I'm going to do is just wipe over with some gel residue wipe off solution to make sure it's nice and clean. We're going to sculpt this out. Tab on the back. Give it a roll. Check how it fits. I need to anchor this up slightly. So you see how the form is going to go up like that. So it's going to come out like this. And it will come straight like this. And then it will go, it'll scoop up. I am going to have to cut this area so it fits a little more snug. Once you're happy with the positioning, you can then close the form. I'm going to dehydrate and prime my nail. So we'll dehydrate and prime. Two coats of primer. I'm going to use soft beige. I'm going to pick up quite a big bead. Pop that straight on to the end of the nail. So we're working the free edge first of all. And you want a straight side wall. And then you're going to bring it into a point. I'm going to angle this a little bit more. Same on both sides. I know you can't really see this side very well at the minute. I just want to build this up a little bit higher. And it's easier because I've made that platform already to work on. We're going to do the cuticle area now. And what I'm going to do is get a tool and I'm going to cut this edge with a blade. make sure both sides are the same. I'm going to have to pinch it. I can feel it getting warm. And I'm going to file this to get a neat line. Just like you would do if it was a smile line. What you need to bear in mind is that you don't want to disturb the form. Now what we're going to do is get black. So this is pure black. I'm going to bleed it out. And I'm going to put that right along the edge. And we're going to come straight, and then we're going to slope up. We're going to do the same on the opposite side. And what we're going to do now is I do need to build up my apex at the back a little bit, so I'm going to do that. Then I'm going to get clear acrylic, this is crystal clear. I'm going to pick up a bead. I am not going to bleed it out. However, I'm going to clean this as a little bit of glitter. So I'm basically just going to cap this black at the end. Just to give a bit of strength. Need that to set. Once that's set, you're going to take the form off. And then I'm going to file straight. And I'm going to go with the angles that we've created. We've got a nice straight side wall, and then we've got it angled at the end. You want to make sure both sides are the same, which is probably the most difficult part of this nail design. I'm going to do the cuticle area. Then I'm going to contour the top surface. The apex is really important with this nail, it'll give it loads of strength. Once I've filed that, I'm going to buff that, make it nice and smooth. Going to wipe over with some pure acetone. Make it nice and smooth. It'll really smooth out the top layer of the nail. See how nice and sharp the black is at the end of the nail. It's pretty nice. I'm going to top coat using Mega Gloss. And I love this look. That skinny black right at the tip looks so cool. It looks really nice on a stiletto as well. I'm going to cure that in the lamp. Using clear acrylic, I'm going to put some stones on. When I'm putting large stones on, I will use a bead of acrylic, and then I'll build around the large stone with other stones.
To hide the acrylic?
Yeah, it can hide the acrylic, and what it does, it supports the large stone. So we're going to feed some in here now. Make sure you keep it clean, take off any excess. And then for the little stones, I'm going to use Mega Gloss. Use a dotting tool to just go around. Just going to push the gel around the outside, which is also going to help hold the stones on. Going to do one side at a time. When people say to me, well, how much would you charge for that? You know, to do like a lot of stoned work.
Mm.
You know, and sort of gone are the days where I used to actually count how many stones have been used. And,
yeah.
You know, and each stone had a price.
Really?
Yeah, and it's just, them days are gone now because people have that many stones on their nails. Their dad would be like, I'll lose count. So I'd be like, so now I'll go, well, you've got a big one, so that's such and such, and you've got about that many. And so I have to, you know, give a rough price really now, more than an exact price. Going now, well, how much for that stone? So for these stones, they are Swarovski stones. I would charge around anything between £8 and £10 on top of the service.
For that amount of stones?
For this amount of stones, yeah. Make sure you're happy with the positioning of your stones before you cure them. Did anybody count how many stones there were? I didn't. So you can see there's quite a few stones there. And we've got some smoke, like a smoky grey. We've got AB stones and we've got gold ones as well. Gold ones to match the theme. Lovely shape, absolutely lovely. It looks very classy as well, I think. Gonna finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. Much needed because my fingers get battered. Lovely jubbly. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check out the next one so we can do my ring finger. Doesn't have a ring on there. But yes, check out the next video. All the products I've used today in this video will be listed below as always. And I'll see you in the next one. Come on, let's keep going. Bye-bye.
They look like little metal pans, and there's one that big, and that's like 3 cups, and then that's 2 cups, and then that's 1 cup.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so you get like a little pan set.
So it's not like a little cup of tea cup?
No.
See, I would be thinking it was like a cup, like, yeah, a cup of tea cup.
Exactly. So it's because they don't speak English.
Ah.
They speak American, don't they?
Ah.
So.
Such a different language.
It's so is. It's so is.
So is.